Students, in the last video, we have already learnt the electronic configuration of actinides, that is from actinium to curium. So today we will move with next, the atomic number 96 to 103 elements electronic configuration, that is curium to lawrencium, atomic number 96 to 103. Now, the electronic configuration of actinides. So first we'll take the elements, that is curium to lawrencium. Atomic number 96 to 103. First, that is the ideal electronic configuration, as already we have discussed, according to their increasing order of energy level. That is above principle. If you follow according to that, if you write the electronic configuration, then it is called ideal electronic configuration. So in this, curium and lawrencium are two exceptional cases. In these two, there will be 5f, 6d and 7s orbitals. So in that actinium, lawrencium are having 14 electrons. Actinium is having 0, it is a vacant orbital, but lawrencium is a completely filled, it is a 14 electron. They are extra stable. Now, if the atomic number increases, even the electron goes on increases. Okay, now see, only difference we are getting here, 6d1, 7s2 is a common here. Then remaining in all element, the atomic number increases, the electron goes on increases. You can see first one is 5f7, that is curium. Then next comes atomic number 97, 5f8. Then atomic number 98, 5f9, 99, 5f10, atomic number 100, 5f11. Only one electron goes on increasing in a 5f orbital. 6d and 7s is common. 6d1 electron is there, 7s, 2 electrons is there. So one electron in a penultimate cell and in a valence cell, 2 electrons are there. Only you are getting the difference in pre-penultimate cell. With atomic number increases, the pre-penultimate cell electrons goes on increases. Now already we know from spectral analysis, it is observed that there is a little deviation in electronic configuration, and therefore two electronic configurations are assigned. So in that, already we know that is a vacant orbital, half-filled orbital and completely filled orbital. That is nothing but f orbitals. Half-filled, completely filled, vacant orbital. These are extra stable. Due to these concept, so the one more electronic configuration is assigned. That is that we will call it as observed electronic configuration. So in this, the element actinium, curium and lawrencium possesses single electron in 6d subshell. In case of other actinides, 6d orbital is empty. Only actinium, curium and lawrencium are having 6d1 electron, but remaining all the elements, all actinides, 6d orbital is empty. You can see here, curium is having 1 electron in 6d, 7 electrons in f orbital, 2 electrons in s in remaining orbital. Even you can see lawrencium, 5f14, 6d1, 6s2. In remaining orbital what happens? So one electron, it may shift to 5f or 5f to 6d. So here, in idealized electronic configuration, the single electron in 6d subshell is retained, while in an observed electronic configuration, the single electron shift to 5f. So single electron from 6d to 5f, it will shift in an observed electronic configuration. In ideal electronic configuration, it is retained, means it is in a 6d orbital only. But in observed electronic configuration, what happens? The 6d electron, it will move to the 5f orbital. That you can see here. See atomic number 97. It is 5f8, 6d1, 7s2. Now what happens in observed electronic configuration? The one electron will move to the 5f orbital. Now same way, in idealized electronic configuration, filling up 5f orbital is regular. In observed electronic configuration, filling 5f orbitals is not irregular. So in observed electronic configuration, filling 5f is irregular, and filling in ideal electronic configuration, filling 5f is regular. So according to increasing order of their energy level. So observed configuration involves of the single electron from 6d to 5f subshell. Now in remaining all cases, what happens? The 6d1 electron, it will shift to the 5f. So this is nothing but observed electronic configuration of actinides. So in case of 102 also, you can see 5f14 completely filled, extra stabilities. Now next one, we will move with oxidation states of actinides. Oxidation states of actinides. In that, Already we know oxidation state means what? The net numerical charge present on an atom of an element in its combined state is known as oxidation state or oxidation number. Already we know the net numerical charge present on an atom of an element in its combined state is known as oxidation state or oxidation number. So all the F block elements are metal, already we know. So metals have tendency to lose the electron. If it loses the electron, then it shows positive oxidation state. It shows positive oxidation state. Now the general electronic configuration of F block element is N minus 2 F 1 to 14, that is a pre penultimate cell, N minus 1 D 0 to 1 penultimate cell, then NS 2. Now all actinides show common oxidation state plus 3. All actinides show common oxidation state plus 3 because, so here also the penultimate one electron is there and the valence cell two electrons are there. Easily the metal can lose these three electrons, that's why the actinides show a common oxidation state plus 3. In addition to plus 3 oxidation state, the actinides show variable oxidation state, that is plus 2 to plus 7. But lanthanides, plus 3 is a common oxidation state. In lanthanides, plus 3 is a common oxidation state, and except plus 3, plus 2 and plus 4. But in lanthanides, what happens? Plus 3 is a common, plus 2 and plus 4. Other than in actinides, what happens? Other than plus 3, there will be variable oxidation state. It may be plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6, plus 7. So your variable oxidation state is possible in actinides. Now, oxidation states of actinides, in that you can see I told like lanthanides, actinides also show variable oxidation states. It is due to availability of 5F, 6D and 7S subshells. The most common state is plus 3 oxidation state. But in lanthanides, we can see only plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation state other than plus 3. But here in actinides, we can see variable oxidation states. We can see here plus 2 oxidation state elements, plus 3 is a common for all. The elements, that is AM and thorium, show plus 2 oxidation state in some of the compounds. So other than that, even plus 3, plus 4, you can see plus 5 and plus 6 is also possible. The exhibition of a large number of oxidation states of actinides is due to the fact of there is a very small energy gap between 5F, 6D and 7S. So due to a small energy gap between 5F, 6D and 7S subshell, so those electrons participate in the bond formation. That's why the actinides are having variable oxidation state. The energy gap between 5F, 6D and 7S is less. The electron participate in the bonding. Hence, the actinides are having variable oxidation states. See, plus 2 to plus 7. Variable oxidation states, actinides. When the oxidation number increases to plus 6, the actinide ions are no longer simple. The high charge density causes the formation of oxygenated ions. So if the oxidation state is plus 6, then there will be formation of oxygenated ions. So oxygenated oxo ions, you can say oxygenated ions or oxo ions formation takes place. Now, the chemical properties and uses of lanthanides and actinides, that is the F block elements. Chemical properties and uses of the lanthanides and actinides. So, chemical reactions of lanthanides. So, here, in general, we will take lanthanide. So, we can take here, instead of LN, we can take any element from lanthanide series or first transition series, first inner transition series. So, out of 14 elements, we can take any one element. And if you take that element, F block elements or lanthanide series element, and if you treat with the hydrogen, then you will get respective hydrides. You will get lanthanide hydrides. So respective hydrides you will get. So if you take any lanthanide series element, if you treat with the carbon, then you will get lanthanide carbides. You will get lanthanide carbides. Same way, if the lanthanides are treated with dilute acids, then it will liberate hydrogen. It will liberate a hydrogen. Then if the lanthanides element, if you treat with the oxygen, then it will form respective oxide. So with plus 3 oxidation state element, should the F block element will be having plus 3 common oxidation state. With respect to that, the respective oxide will be formed. Then when it is treated with the nitrogen, then the nitrites will be formed. So with respect to plus 3 oxidation state. Then when it is reacted with the sulfur or heated with the sulfur, So lanthanide sulfides, so respective sulfides are formed. Same way, when it is treated with the water, lanthanides are treated with the water, it will form lanthanide hydroxide. Here also with respect to plus 3 oxidation state, because plus 3 is a common oxidation state. So these are the chemical reactions of lanthanides. So in general, we have taken LN here. LN means you can take any of the lanthanide series element. Now, the uses of lanthanides. So lanthanide is used as a mixed metal, that is a lanthanum metal, iron, and traces of sulfur, carbon, calcium, and aluminium. Then it is also used to manufacture bullets and shells, and mixed oxides are used as a catalysts. Then uses of actinides. In that first one, uses of thorium, it is used in atomic reactors and in the treatment of cancer. Its salts are used in making incandescent gas mantles. Then uses of uranium, it is used as a nuclear fuel. Its salts are used in glass industry, textile industry, ceramic industry, and in medicine. Then uses of plutonium, it is used as a fuel for atomic reactor as well as for making atomic bombs. Now the last one, comparison between lanthanide and actinide. So here this differences between lanthanide and actinide is very important for 2 marks with respect to theory examination. So differences between or comparison between lanthanide and actinide. So in the differences between lanthanides and actinides, the first one with respect to properties will differentiate. So first property with respect to oxidation state. So here lanthanides and actinides are having plus 3 oxidation state. It is a common oxidation state. So lanthanides other than plus 3, plus 2 and plus 4 oxidation states are possible. But actinides other than plus 3, variable oxidation states are possible, that is plus 2, 2, plus 7. The next one, binding energy. So in a lanthanides, higher binding energy is there due to 4F4 series. Then in actinides, the lower binding energy is there. It is a 5F series. The next one, complex formation. So they have low tendency. Actinides have the low tendency to form a complex compounds. But actinides are having variable oxidation state and they have more tendency to form complex compounds. Then basic character. Their oxides and hydroxides are less basic. Then actinides, whatever the oxides and the hydroxides are there, they are more basic. Then next difference, that is depends upon radioactivity. So in lanthanides, only promethium is a radioactive and remaining lanthanides are non-active. In actinides, all actinides are radioactive. They may be natural radioactive or artificial radioactivity. The next one, color. So some of the tri-positive ions are colored, means in plus 3 oxidation state, the ions are colored in lanthanides. So most of the positive ions are colored. So whichever the oxidation state, variable oxidation state actinides are there, they are colored. The next one, paramagnetic nature. So their paramagnetic nature can be easily explained. Lanthanide paramagnetism can easily explain, but actinide paramagnetism cannot be explained easily. Last one, formation of oxoions. So lanthanides, they do not form oxoions, but actinides form oxoions.